Electric scooters are dotted all over our cities, but they're dividing public opinion, mainly due to safety concerns.
They're causing controversy overseas as well. And in Paris, they're about to be banned.
Cheap to run, quiet, clean, and a great way to get from A to B. But scooters are falling out of favour with the French, and fast. After a spate of accidents, Paris is looking to ban them on safety grounds. Here at home, they're causing concern too. Over the last 4 years, ACC's received more than 10,000 e-scooter claims, costing more than $30 million. So do the pros outweigh the cons? Or should we follow the French and send our scooters off into the sunset?
An e-scooter enthusiast and owner of the electric scooter shop, Jono Leonard, is here now. And thanks for your time, Jono. We just heard about what's happening in Paris. Is there pressure to ban scooters here?
No, I think in New Zealand it's probably quite the opposite, in fact. Auckland Transport have reached out to us for some ideas on how they can increase the use of micro-mobility, specifically e-scooters in our case. And Auckland Transport are currently running activations in shopping malls around the place, again, encouraging people to take a look at e-scooters, to use e-scooters to connect their journeys. So I think we're very much moving in the opposite direction to what's going on in Paris.
Well, if you think about Paris, do you think in that particular case it's a case of penalising everybody for the mistakes of a minority?
Yeah, I think that's possibly the case. I mean, we've also got to look at private scooters and rental scooters in two separate categories, really. And in Paris, they've banned rental scooters specifically. You can still own private scooters.
Jono, why are they a good choice of transport in the city?
Oh, look, the scooters are incredible, really. Once you've got on board, literally, it really does change your life. I mean, they shorten distances. They allow, in the case of a privately owned scooter, it allows someone to scooter from home, hop on a bus, take it with them, hop off. So they really do empower people to take their journey into their own hands.
So would you say then that the benefits of scooters outweigh the risks? Because there are still risks.
Yeah, that is true. There are risks, but there's risks with walking, there's risks with driving, risks with anything really. I think the benefits are innumerate. We're seeing scooter adoption among other people. New Zealand Defence Force have scooters from us, a lot of corporates, a lot of small businesses in the city for zooming around and visiting clients, and a massive number of private individuals who use their scooters for, you know, commuting to work along congested roads. So, you know, the ability to shorten your journeys and to guarantee the time that you're going to arrive because you're avoiding all that horrible traffic and you're not contributing to that horrible traffic just makes scooters an absolute no-brainer, in my opinion.
And, Jono, what sort of safety measures are there at the moment for scooters, and do we need more, perhaps?
In terms of rental scooters, then they are geofenced, meaning that they're restricted to a lower speed in the central, most congested parts of the city. I think that's a good thing. Initially, they weren't supplied with helmets. Now they are, although helmets are not compulsory. So I fail to see why helmets are compulsory on bicycles and they're not compulsory on e-scooters. I mean, as a business, we're adamant about helmets. We provide them for all test rides. We insist people have a helmet when they buy a scooter or they already own a helmet. I do think there could be a little bit of improvement around signage and encouraging people to become better educated about how they utilise scooters.
And, Jono, what would be your message to scooter riders and the pedestrians they share the footpath with?
My message would be ride with care for scooter riders. Look at the options of where you can ride, and if there's a better option than the pavement, then utilise that. You know, ride with care and we can all get along. There's plenty of space for us all.
Thank you so much, Jono. Good to talk to you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.